Okay, good morning to all the students. Today we are going to discuss elasticity because our subject strength of material is totally depend on the elasticity. In the strength of material, what happened? We deal with the structure. Basically, the strength of material subject is belongs to the more familiar with the civil engineering, but most of the part is belongs to the mechanical engineering also, because we deal with the mechanical property of the materials. Okay, so what happened when we talk about any structure? Okay, like building a structure made from the concrete, or the tower structure which is made from the metals. Okay, so to carry more load by the structure, we apply the metals with the concrete. Okay, like you see this making of the bridge, making of the road, and making of the buildings, they use metals inside the building in with the cement and concrete. So the strength of the structure is increased. So in the first lecture, from the first lecture, I always talk about the elasticity, because when we going to manufacture any component, okay, any component or product or structure, the main important thing, deformation should be within the elastic limit. Deformation should be within the elastic limit. So what does it mean? What does it mean? It means that whatever the load apply, and after removal of the load, deformation should remove. Whatever the deformation is produced, that is removed. You think about that. If any building structure, when the public or other load is applied on the building, and the building show the plastic deformation, then what happened? It is a very critical situation. So elasticity is much, much important in the field of strength of material. So today we talk about the elasticity. What is elasticity? You well know, because I already told you the definition, and so you graph stress strain diagram, which is totally depend on the elasticity. Okay, so here you can see how you are going to utilize elastic property when you deal with the manufacturing of the product. Okay, so in today lecture, we are going to discuss elasticity, elastic of composite, viscosity, elasticity of crystal. Okay, but last 2 point, viscoelasticity and elasticity of crystal, is not your syllabus, but for the sake of the knowledge, we have to go for that. Okay. Before starting, we have some observation. We have some observation. What are these observations? When you pull a rubber band, when you pull a rubber band and release it, the band regains its original length. That is an example of elasticity. It is much more difficult, require more load to extend a metal wire as compared to rubber string. That is true. Okay, there is no problem. Means if we want to extend a metal wire, that is the need more load in comparison to the we stretch the rubber wire or rubber string. Okay, so here we can say that next thing, it is difficult to extend a straight metal wire. However, if it is coiled in the form of a spring, one get considerable extension easily. Okay, so what is that? That is a metal wire difficult to extend, but when we go to make that metal wire convert into a spring, then what happens? They can easily extend by a very less load. Okay, and you know what is the advantage of spring, metal spring, what is the application of metal spring? That is, you always see that in the automobile sector, it is very important and useful product, that is a spring. Okay, we use in suspension system, we use it in a brake system, and you see the spring application in your home mode sofa set, okay, domestic sofa set. That is the application of the spring. Okay, so the meaning of all the conclusion, we very much needed the elasticity. And what is the elasticity? It is clear, when we apply a load on a component or metal and remove that load, the metal or component regains its original position. Okay, now a driver get lift off using the elastic energy stored in the diving board. If the diving board is too complete, then driver can't be get sufficient lift off. That is true. A rim of metal is heated to extend the loop and then fitted around a wooden wheel. So on the cooling of the rim, it is tightly fit around the wheel. So these are the example of elasticity. इलास्टिसिटी। ओके सो यस, इलास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन इज रिवर्सिबल डिफॉर्मेशन, इट इज वन ऑफ द डेफिनेशन। इलास्टिसिटी इज रिलेटेड टू द डिफॉर्मेशन विच इज रिवर्सिबल, मीन्स डिफॉर्मेशन बट वेन वी रिमूव द लोड द डिफॉर्मेशन इज रिमूव्ड। वेन लोड फोर्स आर कॉन्स्टेंट आर रिलीज द बॉडी रिटर्न टू द ओरिजिनल शेप एंड साइज। ओके, इलास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन कैन बी कॉजेज बाई द टेंशन कंप्रेशन आर शियर फोर्स। ओके सो वी नो देयर इज थ्री टाइप ऑफ लोड बाई विच डिफॉर्मेशन इज अकर, टेंशन कंप्रेशन शियर फोर्स। ओके, वन फोर्स, वन मोर फोर्स इज देयर दैट इज वी कॉल द टॉर्सनल फोर्स। ओके, बट इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ शियर फोर्स। सो when we study not in deep, then shear forces we can say that torsional force is a type of shear force. Okay, usually in metal and ceramic elastic deformation is seen at low strain less than 10 to power minus 3 10 to power minus 3 mm. Okay, unit is missing here. And at higher strain, it addition to elastic deformation, we get plastic deformation. Okay, so what happens here, you can see the graph, two graphs is here, you can see the graph. So by the graph, this is sigma y and this is epsilon. So I already told you in different books different symbol used for the stress and strain. Okay, somewhere for the strain small e is used and somewhere this epsilon symbol is used and somewhere for the stress F is used, but here sigma is used. So you can see the plastic means there is, you can see elastic deformation divided into the two forms, linear and nonlinear. Okay, what is the meaning of linear? The meaning of linear is that the stress and strain increase in a linear form, in a linear line. So you can see OA is a linear form means what is the value of stress is increases as proportionally your strain should be increases. Okay, so nonlinear, what is the meaning of nonlinear? Means deformation not follow the linearity, deformation is not follow the linearity. So see here, aluminium deformation at a small strain, example deformation of an elastomer like a rubber. See, the rubber elasticity is more, means we can apply the load and deformation is not linear, this is inlinear, but within the elastic limit, but within the elastic limit. Okay, see, this is the example of linear deformation or linear elasticity deformation, and this is the example of non-linear deformation but in the elastic form. but in the elastic form. So the elastic behavior of metal and ceramic is usually linear. The elastic behavior of metal and ceramic is usually linear. Okay, see here, metal and ceramic is linear. The stress strain curve is linear. See, but for the rubber, the elastic deformation is not linear. It is non-linear. So you can see this is not non-linear. We get the curve shape for the deformation. Now, time dependent aspects of elastic deformation. Okay. It's normal elastic behavior when a small load is applied to a metal wire causes a strain within elastic limit. It is assumed that the strain is appear instantly. Okay. So what happened means when we apply the small load on the metal wire, then what happened? Deformation is shown. But when we remove, there is no time to wire gets its original position. Wire gets its original position. So now, similarly, when load beyond the elastic limit is applied in a uniaxial tension, it is assumed that the plastic strain develops instantaneously. It is further assumed that the load is applied quasi-static. Means, quasi-static means what happened? The deformation is very slow. And when we remove the load, the regain process or elastic process is also slow. Okay. However, in some case, the elastic or plastic strain need not develop instantly. Okay. So what happened? The elongation may take place at constant load with time. These effects are termed analysis. What is the meaning of analysis? It is depend on the annealing forces. So the term is called the analysis. For the time dependent elastic deformation at a constant load and viscoelasticity. Okay, so what is the analysis means? What happened? Sometime what happened? We apply a load in a material, okay, or metal, then the deformation is not shown instantly. So what happened? With the time, deformation is increasing. With the time, deformation is increasing. So that is the time dependent deformation. That is the time dependent deformation. Okay. So these term call is the analysis and viscoelasticity. Okay. Anelastic material are a subset of the viscoelastic material. In inelastic material, the strain is fully recoverable. Means, what is the meaning of recoverable? Means, in the inelastic material, the strain is fully recoverable. Means, when the load is removed, whatever the deformation is there, that is regain its original position. Okay. So, and in the dynamic loading, the strain stress रिस्पॉन्स डिपेंड ऑन द फ्रिक्वेंसी, विस्को इलास्टिक रिस्पॉन्स डिपेंड ऑन द रेट ऑफ द लोडिंग स्ट्रेन रेट. ओके सी हियर इन दिस ब्लॉक डायग्राम डिफॉर्मेशन इलास्टिक एंड प्लास्टिक मीन्स इलास्टिक मीन्स रिकवरेबल मीन्स द वॉट एवर द डिफॉर्मेशन दैट इज रिकवर. प्लास्टिक परमानेंट डिफॉर्मेशन. तो इन द इलास्टिक देयर इज फर्दर डिवाइड इन टू द टू टाइप इंस्टेंटेनियस. इंस्टेंटेनियस मीन्स वेन वी लोड वी अप्लाई द लोड डिफॉर्मेशन इज शोन. वेन वी अप्लाइड द लोड एट दैट टाइम डिफॉर्मेशन इज शोन. बट अदर इज टाइम डिपेंडेंट. वॉट हैपन सम लोड इज देयर मीन्स वी अप्लाई द लोड इंस्टेंटेनियस देयर इज नो डिफॉर्मेशन. इंस्टेंटेनियस देयर इज नो डिफॉर्मेशन बट फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम ड्यूरेशन फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम ड्यूरेशन देयर इज अ डिफॉर्मेशन दैट इज द टाइम डिपेंडेंट. सिमिलरली हियर द प्लास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन इज instantly we see the deformation plastic deformation and that is the time dependent. Okay, if plastic deformation is time dependent that is we called viscoelasticity. See the term and it is maybe asked in the your examination. What is the anelastic, what is the anelasticity and what is the viscoelasticity. Anelasticity is the elastic deformation which is time dependent. Anelasticity is the elastic deformation which is time dependent and viscoelasticity is the permanent deformation with the time dependent. Okay, so that is the main difference between the anelasticity and the anelasticity and the viscoelasticity. Okay, now we talk about the atomic model for the elasticity. At the atomic level, elastic deformation takes place by the deformation of bonds. Change in the bond length or bond angle. Okay, so there is atoms. Okay, so what happen? All the material, all the component, whatever things or whatever the matter available in the world, that is made from the atoms. So we can say that the most smallest unit for building anything or any material that is atoms. Okay. So what I meant, now we going to atomic model of the elasticity. So whatever the material is available, that is all things is made from the atoms, and atoms, we can say that atoms is the smallest unit for any product, material, whatever the things available. Okay. So at the atomic level, elastic deformation takes place by the deformation of the bonds. Means what happened? A lot of numbers of atom available in the product or material. So atomic deformation will take place. It is increase the length between two atoms. It is increase the length between two atoms, or it is change the angle between two atoms. Okay, understand? एटॉमिक डिफॉर्मेशन, और वी कैन से द इलास्टिक एटॉमिक डिफॉर्मेशन विल टेक प्लेस व्हेन द लेंथ इंक्रीज आर डिक्रीज, और वी कैन से दैट लेंथ इज चेंज बिटवीन टू एटम्स, और द एंगल इज चेंज, बॉन्ड एंगल इज चेंज बिटवीन टू एटम्स, दैट इज द इलास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटम्स। ओके, नाउ लेट्स कंसीडर द स्ट्रेचिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड, मीन्स स्ट्रेचिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड, इट इज द लेंथ इंक्रीज बिटवीन टू एटम्स। स्ट्रेचिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड मीन लेंथ इंक्रीज बिटवीन टू एटम्स। सो एटम्स इन अ सॉलिड फील एंड अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स एट लार्ज एटॉमिक सेपरेशन and feel a repulsive force, feel a repulsive force when electron cloud overlap too much at shorter separation and very large separation, there is no force left. Okay. So, students, there is a force which is we call the force of attraction. Okay. There is a force between two body in the earth, the attraction force means two body attract to each other by a particular force. Okay, and this attraction force is much higher between the same material atoms. Okay, and from the solid, means we can say that solid or metal, the attraction force between two atoms is much higher. Means what happens if we want to change the length between two atoms of a metal, so it need more force in comparison to other materials. Okay, the energy and force, which is gradient of the energy field, display functional behavior as if the equation below. See here, this is now we can see this is about the energy and this is about the force. Okay, so U equal to A, what is A means we can say that it is a component and V is the separate component. Now what happened, Rn and Rm, so what is Rn and Rm, it is the radius of the A and radius of the B. Repulsive, this is repulsive, and here F equal to Na divided by R n plus 1, Mb divided by R n plus b. So we convert Na is a constant, so we called it A dash and B dash. So now there is one simple form of interatomic potential, also called the Lerner-John potential, when m equal to 12 and n equal to 6, the value of m and n given here MNN, 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 like this. So if put the value MNN, because AB MNN is the constant, M is greater than N. So here we take the value for this Lorentz-Jones potential, M equal to 12 and N equal to 6. Now, the plot of the interatomic potential and force function show that at the equilibrium, interatomic separation or not, the potential energy of the system is a minimum and force exceeded to zero. If reality, the atoms are undergoing the thermal vibration about the equilibrium position, the amplitude of the vibration increases with the increasing the temperature. Due to the slight left-right asymmetry about the minimum in the U or port, increasing the thermal vibration lead to an expansion of the crystal. So see here, equilibrium separation of the atoms. What happened? The green curve shown the attractiveness, and this is repulsive. The red line is shown the repulsive. So what happened? It is about the potential energy. This graph shows the potential energy, and this graph belongs to the force. Okay. Now, see. Now, the most important factor is coming here. Young modulus. Young modulus is the slope of the force interatomic spacing curve. At the equilibrium interatomic separation, for example, it is the curvature of the energy displacement interatomic separation plot. So see here, this is the force, and what is the Young modulus? Young modulus y upon e. Young modulus is potential to the negative slope of the ER curve. So see here, this is our stress and strain. So, and this is our compression. This is tension, this is compression. Both are the stress strain curve. So this slope is here, is the Young modulus, and here this green is the slope which is indicate the Young modulus. For displacement, around the force, displacement curve is approximately linear. See here, for the linear elasticity region or for the elastic deformation with the proportional limit, In the reality of the elastic module, in the four tensor, see, tension is there. Due to the tension, the E is there. So Y, what is Y? Y is directly proportional to, it is the symbol of directly proportional to. The Y is directly proportional to dF divided by dr. Okay. So Y is directly proportional to dF dr, which is equal to d2u and dr squared. This is about the symbols of calculation. This is the मैथमेटिकल पार्ट, तो यू कैन सी दीज थिंग्स इन द फर्स्ट ईयर मैथमेटिक्स सिलेबस, तो दैट इज बिलोंग्स टू द कैलकुलस. सो नाउ अगेन वी गो फॉर द फर्दर इन द स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व. इन मेटल एंड द सेरेमिक द इलास्टिक स्ट्रेन, द स्ट्रेन बियॉन्ड विच प्लास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन सेट इज आर फ्रैक्चर टेक प्लेस, अ वेरी स्मॉल दैट इज वेरी स्मॉल 10^-3. As these strain are very small, it is not matter if we use engineering stress strain or true stress strain value. The stress strain plot is linear for such a material. So what happened for the metal and ceramic? There is no difference between engineering stress and stress strain and the true stress strain value, because the deformation or strain value is very small. So we can say that there is no difference between engineering stress and true stress. Okay. Now for the polymer, which special reference to the elastomer. Polymers is the special reference for the elastomer. So non-linear stress strain behavior in the elastic region. So that is the rubber. The example is the rubber. Okay. Rubber is so the non-linear deformation in the elastic region. This paragraph belongs to the polymer or rubber. Okay. Rotation of the long chain molecules around a C-C bond, carbon-carbon bond, can cause tensile elongation. The elastic strain can be large in the elastomer. Sometimes can even extend a few 100%. What happened? You see what is the length of a rubber string and how much we can stretch them. So the elongation of that rubber string sometime 2-3 times of its original length. Okay, means if the rubber string length is 5 or 6 centimeter, then we can easily extend it to 15, 20, or 25 centimeter. Okay, like this. So that's why it is written here, some can extend a few 100%. Means, what is the meaning of 100%? We can increase the length 100%. Means, we can increase in the double length. Means, if L is there, so we can extend it and make it 2L. That is the 100%. Extension, and if we make it 3L means 200% we can increase the length. Okay, so it is very small. Additionally, the behavior of elastomer is compression is different from the tension. Okay, there is no problem. So see here, this graph is for the elastomer, means that is for the rubber. So what happens? See, in the tension, for the same load, in the tension, the deformation is more. For the deformation is more, but for the same load in the compression, deformation is less. So epsilon c is shown the strain in the compression, and epsilon t show the deformation or strain in the tension. So you can see there is always epsilon t is greater than epsilon c. Okay, means strain in tension is always greater than strain in compression. Okay, for the elastomer material. See, other elastic module. So see here, E is Young modulus, G is shear modulus, K is bulk modulus, and mu is the Poisson ratio. Mu is the Poisson ratio. So these are other modules for the elasticity. Now what happened? We have to, there is a problem which is mostly come in your examination. What is the relationship between E, G, K? What is the relationship between E, G, K and Poisson ratio? Okay, so maybe if your exam conduct offline, then this problem may be occur in your examination. Show the or drive the relationship between three elastic moduli. Elastic moduli. So these are the modules of elasticity: E, Young modulus, shear modulus, and bulk modulus. And we have to show the relation between these three. Relationship between these three. So now we go for that. We have to note the elastic module in the fourth rank tensor. A normal material is symmetric tensor. Okay. In parasit, in practice, many of these components may be zero, and additionally many of them may have the same value. For example, a cube crystal, there are only three independent constant. Okay, in two index constant notation, these are the E11, E12, E44. For an isotropic material, the number of independent constant is only two. Typically, these are the chosen as E and G, two in principle, which could choose any other two, and these moduli are the interrelated for the isotropic material. Okay. So now we can explain here. See, these are the property and these are the magnitude for particular material. For particular material, the Young modulus be denoted by YRE. YRE means we can make symbol for the Young modulus, that is Y and E. So most of the book refers. E is the Young modulus. Capital E is the Young modulus. Most of the book refer E, but some book is so Y as a Young modulus. Okay, Poisson ratio, the value is 0.3 for most of the material. Shear modulus G, that is also constant. That is 26.9 gigapascal. And 70 gigapascal. Okay, bulk modulus 58.3 gigapascal, and Lamb constant denoted by the lambda. We can say the symbol is लाइक अ इनवर्स वाई, ओके, बट दिस इज नॉट से लाइक द इनवर्स वाई, दिस इज द लेमडा, वी कॉल इट लेमडा, दैट इज द लैम कॉन्स्टेंट 40.4 गीगापास्कल. ओके, सो वट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इलास्टिक कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ एन आइसोट्रोपिक मटेरियल. We have to note that for an isotropic material, the elastic property are described by two independent elastic constants, typically E and mu. The other elastic constant like bulk modulus and the shear modulus G or mu can be derived from these constants by the फॉर्मूला. लिस्ट ऑफ इलास्टिक फॉर द आइसोट्रोपिक मटेरियल, यंग मॉडुलस वाई आर ई, पॉइजन रेशियो म्यू, शियर मॉड्यूल जी आर म्यू, बल्क मॉडुलस के, लैम कॉन्स्टेंट लेमडा, पी वेव मॉडुलस एम. द रिलेटिव मैग्नीट्यूड फॉर दीज कॉन्स्टेंट कैन बी सीन फ्रॉम द टेबल बिलो. So these are things. Now see, G equal to E upon 2 in bracket 1 plus mu, that is Poisson ratio. K equal to E and M equal to also E. So if we make the formula, what is E? So that is K into 3 in bracket 1 minus 2 mu. What is E? G into 2, 1 plus B. And what is E from here? M into 1 plus B, 1 minus 2B divided by 1 minus B. So all the formula comes in the form of modulus of elasticity or N modulus. So we can make a new formula from that. Now see, this is the Poisson ratio and initial configuration in the respect to zero in subscribe. So what happened? B naught here and B I is here, L and L naught. So what happened? See, what is the difference? B naught means it is the initial brick. And BI is the final breath. So what happened? The girth of the material is reduced and length is increased. Okay? Means in the X direction, that is the compression. X direction, there is compression in the dimension. And in the Y direction, that is the elongation in the dimension. That is the elongation in the dimension. So, students, there is any question till here?